Thanks, Ken Corlett. Minister, you tell us that you believe that your package will be seen as fair by the majority of people and that it will be accepted as fair by the majority of Irish people. Well, I can only tell you that that is further proof of how absolutely out of touch this government is. You really just don't get it. People have gone way beyond the idea of tinkering with this toxic entity. The only thing that will satisfy the population at this stage is the abolition of water charges in their entirety, the recognition that water is a public human right, a public service which should be funded from progressive central taxation, and that the Irish water entity is so ill-conceived that it can never work. And you would do the taxpayer a favour by abandoning that now and failing to continue to throw good money after bad. And if you don't, it will indeed be your legacy. It will be a total legacy to your arrogance. And I think, you know, it's a bit of a sick joke that things have got so ridiculous in your statements that you tried to tell us that we could actually make money out of it if we worked our water meters well. I mean, seriously. But in any case, who would believe ye anymore? You are the same people who in the last weeks and months told us that you had to have the PPS numbers to make the scheme work. Now you don't. The levies had to be at the amounts being demanded by the CER. Now they don't. You told us you didn't need to change the law to protect Irish water from privatisation because it was there already. Now you're changing it. Your backflipping really would be the envy of a professional acrobat, because everybody knows the only reason you're making these changes is in the face of an unprecedented people's movement. Everybody knows that your desperate efforts here are simply trying to hook people in so that you can get the charge established, and once you do, it's going to rise relentlessly. And it's precisely for that reason that you will fail, because people have made it clear that they can't pay, they won't pay. They're utterly sick of managing, of getting up early in the morning, of working longer and harder for less. And your idea of dressing up this extortion as a means of improving the water infrastructure is frankly insulting. The Taoiseach made the point last night that she was shocked to hear of raw sewerage going into the sea. Well, I was shocked that she was shocked, because the dogs on the streets know that that's the case. So why don't she fix it? You'd think there was never any investment in the infrastructure in this state. There was, and when it was made, it worked well. But your government and the one before you managed to slash investment in water infrastructure by 70% since 08. Not only that, capital programmes which were underway were axed when Irish Water came on the scenes. Projects planned by the local authorities were shelved. You haven't put a single water butt onto a government building, not to mind dealing with anything else in terms of conservation. And instead, you've decided to continue to throw away hundreds of millions of taxpayers' money on the installation of water meters, despite previous studies saying that that was an uneconomic proposition in the context of the revenue generated, and despite the fact that you've abandoned it anyway because you've reverted to a flat charge where millionaires are going to pay the same as people on social welfare. Taoiseach, the people know that we've paid for our water supply already. 1.2 billion per annum. We're paying twice now through 700 million of property tax and pension funds being frittered away on Irish water. They've said they're not going to pay a third time so that you can charge us a fourth time by repaying the borrowings. If this was about infrastructure, why did you give tax breaks in the recent budget to the top 17% to the tune of 400 million when this measure now is only going to yield 90 million. You could have addressed it like that. You have made a very serious mistake here today. I think it is an historic day, as the Minister said. Ye had an opportunity to listen. You had an opportunity to step back and abolish the charges on Irish water. You haven't taken that opportunity. And the reality is that nobody can govern against the will of the people. And you've lost the will and the mandate of people. And honestly, your days are now numbered. And if you had any respect for yourself, you really should go to the people and call a general election, because we've had to listen to a lot of waffle about democracy from the Taoiseach over the weekend, aided and abetted by some of his friends in the media, trying to discredit a people's movement, trying to insult people that they would allow themselves to be led by a sinister fringe. Where was the coverage to the 200 women in Coolock who peacefully protested outside the station last night? Those who are undermining democracy are not in the communities. They're sitting across the way there, because ye went to the people. You said, vote for Labour and we'll save you from Fine Gael's water charges. Fine Gael said, vote for us and we'll never bring in a charge unless meters are in. That's not democracy, that is fraud. And you have betrayed the people of this country. You've succeeded in awakening a sleeping giant of the Irish people. And you know what? Now that they're awake, they actually like it and they're not going back into their box. December the 10th will be absolutely enormous, in my opinion. I don't think you'll survive it unless you cop on before that. But if you try and limp along after that date, you will find that this charge will be absolutely uncollectible.
Thank you, Deputy.
By the time you try and bring it in and collect that in April. But I strongly suspect that it's not going to be your problem, because you'll probably be gone before then.